accepted that sin to be drenched to the bone. If your time to you is worth saving, then you better start swimming or you'll sink like a stone. For the times, they are changing.
The countercultural movement of the 60s was a moment in time where our American social constructs came into question. Rather than chiding along with what society required of its participants, people found themselves asking why they needed to participate in the first place. An overarching theme of a society, including governing bodies, is that if we all work together, one doesn't need to worry themselves about the larger mysteries of life because all one needs is in front of them. The classic setup of a hardworking husband, a loyal wife, two rapscallion kids, and a dog, picket fence should be enough, but having these qualities in one's life doesn't answer any questions about our human condition. In fact, it lends more. What this really does is keep you busy. Some will argue it even gives you purpose. Questions are asked constantly about the human condition. It seems as though no answers to these questions can be found in nature. We know the rules of this place, but not what it is, how it came to be, or if there's a reason for it all in the first place. And it is maddening, so frustrating, enough to make people want to jump ship entirely and not participate at all. The counterculture. Fueled partly by psychedelics, but kicked into overdrive by an instinctual need to be free, consisting of people like you or I that finally just said, I'm sick of this. In comes Bob Dylan. A living question, one who calls it like he sees it and is able to put into words thoughts and emotions Americans and folks from around the globe all had, but weren't able to encapsulate.
Now, in order to give you an idea of Dylan's style and rapport of being the spokesman of his generation, here's a live performance of the classic Dylan tune, Blowin' in the Wind.
How many roads must a man walk down before you call him a man? Yes, and how many seas must a white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand? Yes, and how many times must the cannonballs fly before they're forever banned? The answer, my friend, is a blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. Must a mountain exist before it is washed to the sea? Yes, and how many years can some people exist before they're allowed to be free? Yes, and how many times must a man turn his head and pretend that he just doesn't see? My friend, is a blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
Now, here are the lyrics to the song in its entirety. You can see that Dylan has filled each line of this song with provocative and simultaneously unanswerable questions about the human condition, politics, and love. It has been said each line could spur off into its own entirely different song because they each raise such daunting questions with no tangible answer. The sound of Dylan's voice also has a sort of weak timbre to it, which to me makes his songs more heartfelt and longful, as though it's coming from a place that has no choice but to speak out. This is why Dylan is one of the many cultural figureheads of the countercultural movement. He raises the questions that have been toiling inside any respecting human and then puts them in your face through mainstream music, forcing you to come to terms with the reality that most of these questions can't be answered. Though the answers are out there somewhere, just not in this society. The answers lie in more basic human needs like love, acceptance, and peace of mind.